You know, we got a parable in the Bible where Jesus actually says, you're not investing in that talent. And because you're not investing in that talent, I'm going to take it away from you and give it to somebody who's
thankful.
That's right.
I'm going to give it to somebody who's actually going to be thankful about what they're doing.
That's right.
And so in America, we've been brought up with Christianity. We've been brought up. It takes Adrian coming from Mexico to remind us, you took the Bible away.
Yep.
You took prayer away.
Yep.
Most Americans owe so much on their credit card, and they have the audacity to say something against our government for going and spending too much money.
Yeah.
Here's a guy who actually owns a house.
Yeah.
Okay. God is actually saying, if you don't invest in that talent, I'm going to remove it from you and give it to somebody else who's going to be thankful for.
Yeah. Amen.
And so if that isn't a lesson to learn, there's Exhibit A right there of that parable. It's interesting because I am also Hispanic. My parents spoke English in the house, so I know very little Spanish. I can understand it. I just never could enunciate the words. Maybe taco burrito is about as much as I know, but not much Spanish. And one year, we're in a Mardi Gras, and this Spanish guy comes up, and he sees the banner. He pours out his beer. He's crying. He wants to repent. And so he's talking Spanish. And the brothers are saying, well, take him to Reuben. He knows Spanish. Well, I have no idea what this guy's saying. Peter from Norway knows about four different languages. So Peter comes in. And so here I am, born and raised in Los Angeles. My mother was born and raised in L.A. And I'm telling Peter what to say. I'm telling the Norwegian what to tell a Mexican so that we can get this guy saved.
Amen.
Wow. And what a scenario. Welcome to America. But I know very little Spanish. I do live in this country, and I'll tell you, you don't know what it's like unless you leave this country. Mm-hmm. You leave this country, you will come back and probably kiss the ground that we actually live in. I hear so many times, police state. I don't know if you know what a police state is. I've sat in a jail cell in Russia. I've sat in a jail cell in Norway. I've sat in some jail cells across this nation or world that I would go preach at. And it is unique. You talk about a police state. We don't really have it yet. You know it's coming, but let's not fast forward it.
Right.
It's not really as quick as you... Believe me, if you saw the police state in some of these countries that we visited, you would be very thankful. You have to understand, people are risking their lives to die to come and be here. And unfortunately, we've turned our back on God, and there's Exhibit A of why God has removed that talent from so many of us and given it to somebody else who wants to invest. So what a great testimony.
Yeah.